Good afternoon, dignitaries, and all my dear participants. Myself, Neelkamal Bhattu, and today I'm going to present on cyber terrorism threat to national security. So, by Denning, it was defined as cyber terrorism are the unlawful attacks and threats of attack against computers, networks, and the information stored therein when done to intimidate or coerce a government or its people in furtherance of political or social objectives. And as it is said that future wars will not be like traditional wars, which are fought on land, water, or air. Snowden's revelations have shown that cyberspace could become the theater of warfare in the 21st century. We have started considering advanced features only after this revelation. All our vital institutions, installations, and critical infrastructure need to be protected from cyber attacks. The future wars will target crucial areas such as the defense installations, sensitive documents related to internal and external security, communication network including satellites, air traffic control management, railway traffic control, financial services, premier institutions of science and technology. Strategies which can be adopted or implemented to deal with cyber terrorism threats are pursue and prosecute the perpetrator, that is, we must maintain good communication relationship with those still who had already been convicted to extract information from them regarding the future plans. Develop best security practices. Developments are always needed to be updated. Government as well as cyber experts must strive to implement them. Be proactive. Not only the officials but also the civilians must be aware of the situation. Deploy vital security application, that is, use of intrusion detection system, antivirus software should be encouraged. Establish business continuity and disaster recovery plans. Cooperation with various firms and working groups should be established. Increase security awareness. Proper security training programs should be done. Stricter cyber law. The offenses must be non-bailable. And of course, we must encourage research and development in this area. Adequate grants must be useful for conducting researches. Now, the most important aspect of any terrorism is its funding. Recently, in the year 2019, our Honorable Prime Minister had implemented demonetization with a view of curbing funding to terrorism. The same way, we have other transactions which occur, which are the hawala transactions, wherein cashes are transferred from one country's businessman to other through the hawalas. And then cryptocurrency, it was introduced in the year 2009 by Satoshi Nakamoto. Earlier, it had a good view, good intention, but later now it is being rampantly used by all the terrorists across the world for ill purposes. And also the dark web, it is defined, it is a web lying below the surface. If you think of iceberg, above it is the Facebook, Twitter, Gmail, YouTube, etc. But in the entire depth, if we go, it is internet is hiding under the surface because of hidden IP addresses. Now, the steps taken by the government were setting up national critical information protection centers, centers of excellence in cryptology, cyber forensic laboratories, computer emergency response team, then financial computer emergency response team, Cyber Surakshit Bharat Initiative, National Cyber Security Policy in the year 2013. And then there were some amendments in the legal framework, the Information Technology Act 2000. Now, I would like to conclude by saying that on one hand, we have the issues of freedom of expression and right of privacy, while on the other are the issues of hurting religious sentiments. There has to be a fine balance between the two. It is a continuous journey that requires everyone to be committed to it. In many respects connected to cyber terrorism, such as critical infrastructures, businesses, and humans, as well as sometimes taking complex steps to decrease the chances of such attacks from happening. And then, however, all organizations of the government and the public should work together with strong hope of winning the battle. The fact is, cyber terrorism is here to stay and will have a long way. But with the various strategic plans, we are getting closer to achieving our main objective, which is to have highly secure and productive working environment. These are my references. Thank you.